Jeanette Andrabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this video, we are going to explain the energy distribution in a series RC circuit fed by a constant voltage. Explain the energy distribution in the discharging circuit of the capacitor. Determine the expression of the electric energy stored in the capacitor. And solve an example on energy and power in the charging and the discharging circuits of a capacitor.
Let's explain the energy distribution in a series RC circuit fed by a constant voltage. Consider the circuit. We have an ideal battery of electromotive force E, a resistor of resistance R, an uncharged capacitor of capacitance C, and a switch K. The switch is closed at time zero, and the capacitor begins to charge. During the charging of the capacitor, the battery supplies electric energy to the resistor and the capacitor. The electric energy supplied by the battery during a time interval 0t within the charging phase of the capacitor is given by Wg is equal to Wc plus Wr. But what is Wc? Wc is the electric energy stored in the capacitor. And Wr is the thermal energy dissipated in the resistor during this time.
Now, let's explain the energy distribution in a discharging circuit of the capacitor. In this circuit, we have a charged capacitor. This charges through an exterior circuit. The exterior circuit would be a lamp, a resistor, etc. At time zero, we close the switch. So, the charged capacitor discharges through the exterior circuit. So, the electric energy received by the exterior circuit or the energy supplied by the capacitor during a time interval 0t is given by Wc0 minus Wc, where Wc0 is the electric energy stored in the capacitor at time 0, and Wc is the electric energy stored in the capacitor at an instant t.
Let's determine the expression of the electric energy stored in the capacitor. Consider this circuit. We have an ideal battery of electromotive force E, we have a resistor of resistance R, and the capacitor of plates A and B. Take UAB as UC, and here we will use the general expression of the instantaneous power. P is equal to dW by dt. P is the instantaneous power, and W is the energy. For the capacitor, PC is equal to dWc by dt. Wc is the energy, the electric energy stored in the capacitor, and PC is the rate at which electric energy is stored or supplied by the capacitor. But in this circuit, we have a charging phenomenon, then PC represents the rate at which electric energy is stored in the capacitor. Rearrange. So dWc is equal to PC dt. Take the antiderivative of both sides. This is going to be Wc is equal to the antiderivative of PC dt. Generally, the instantaneous electrical power is equal to the current multiplied by the voltage. So PC is equal to IUAB, which is equal to IUC. Replace PC by IUC. This is going to be Wc is equal to the antiderivative of IUC dt. Look at the circuit. The positive sense enters the capacitor through the plate of a charge Q. Then I is equal to plus dq by dt, which is equal to C duc by dt. Replace I by C duc by dt. This is going to be the antiderivative of C duc by dt times uc dt. Dt and dt cancel out. This is going to be the antiderivative C uc duc. Now, to take the antiderivative of this expression, let me remind you with this rule. The antiderivative of x with respect to x is equal to x squared over 2 plus constant. Now take x as uc. So this is going to be c uc squared over 2 plus constant. Now we need to calculate the constant. At the beginning of the charging process, UC is equal to zero and WC is equal to zero because the capacitor stores no electric energy in the beginning of the charging process. So replace WC by zero and UC by zero in this expression. You will get zero equals is equal to zero plus constant. Then the constant is equal to zero. So we still have WC is equal to 1/2 CUC squared. This is the expression of the electric energy stored in a capacitor. An important remark, this expression is used in the charging and in the discharging circuit of the capacitor.
The aim of this experimental simulation is to verify that the charged capacitor stores electric energy. For this aim, consider this circuit, which includes a battery, a resistor, a capacitor, a lamp, and SBDT switch having one input terminal and two output terminals. The graph shows the voltage across the capacitor as a function of time. Let's start the simulation by turning the switch to position 1. We notice that during charging, the voltage across the capacitor increases and becomes constant in the steady state. Now, let's turn the switch to position 2. We observe that the lamp glows and the voltage across the capacitor decreases to zero during the discharging, because during the discharging, the lamp receives electric energy from the capacitor. So we can conclude that the charged capacitor stores electric energy, and this energy depends on the voltage across its terminals.
Let's solve an example about the energy of the capacitor. In this circuit, we have an ideal battery of electromotive force 10 volts, an ohmic resistor of resistance R, an uncharged capacitor of capacitance 20 millifarads, an SPDT switch K, a lamp considered as an ohmic resistor of resistance 20 ohms, and connecting wires. Let's move to the charging process. K is turned to position 1, so the capacitor starts charging. Indicate the component or components that supplies or supply electric energy to the circuit and those which receive electric energy during the charging process. Look at the charging circuit. We know that the battery supplies energy to the resistor and to the capacitor. Therefore, the battery supplies electric energy to the circuit. And the resistor and the capacitor receive electric energy from the battery.
Focus, please. This is important.
Number 2. Calculate the electric energy WC stored in the capacitor when it becomes fully charged. The electric energy stored in the capacitor is given by this formula, WC equal 1/2 CUC squared. But we know that when the capacitor becomes fully charged, the voltage across its terminals is equal to E, or it becomes maximum. So WC equal WC maximum equal 1/2 CE squared. Now replace each physical quantity by its value. C is equal to 20 millifarads, which is equivalent to 20 times 10 to the power minus 3 farads, and E is equal to 10 volts. Therefore, the energy stored in the capacitor when it becomes fully charged is equal to 1 joule. Number 3. By the end of the charging process, the capacitor will have stored an amount of energy equal to that dissipated by the resistor during the whole charging process. Calculate the electric energy given by the battery during the whole charging process. We know that during charging, the energy given by the battery is equal to the energy stored in the capacitor plus the energy dissipated in the resistor. But WR is equal to WC, therefore WG is equal to WC, and WC is equal to 1 joules. Therefore, the energy given by the battery during the whole charging process is equal to 2 joules.
Let's move to the discharging process. K is turned to position 2, so the capacitor starts discharging at an instant taken as a new initial time, 0. Look at the discharging circuit. We have the capacitor and the lamp. The question is, Indicate the component that supplies electric energy to the circuit and the one that receives electric energy during the discharging process. We know that during its discharging, the capacitor acts as a generator and supplies electric energy to the circuit. In this discharging circuit, we have only the lamp as an electrical load, so the lamp receives electric energy from the capacitor.
Number 2. At an instance t equals 0.277 seconds, the voltage you see across the capacitor becomes 0.5E. Part 2A. Determine the electric energy received by the lamp during the time interval 0t. We know that during discharging, the energy received by an exterior circuit is equal to WC0 minus WC, where W exterior circuit is the energy received by the lamp, WC0 is the maximum energy stored in the capacitor at the beginning of the discharging process, and WC is the remaining energy in the capacitor at the time t. Now, let's calculate the value of WC at time t. This energy is given by 1/2 CUC squared. So, replace each physical quantity by its value. C is equal to 20 times 10 to the power minus 3 farads. UC is equal to 0.5E, which is equal to 0.5 times 10. Therefore, the remaining energy in the capacitor at the time t is equal to 0.25 joules. Now, W lamp is equal to WC maximum is proved or calculated in one of the previous slides, which is equal to 1 joules, and WC at the instant t is equal to 0.25 joules. Therefore, W lamp is equal to 0.75 joules. Part 2b. Deduce the average electric power received by the lamp during the time interval 0t. The average power is given by the energy received by the lamp over the time interval delta t, which is equal to W lamp over t minus 0. Now, replace each physical quantity by its value. W lamp is equal to 0.75 joules. T is equal to 0.277 seconds. Therefore, the average power received by the lamp during the time interval 0t is equal to 2.71 watts.
Let's move to part 2c. Determine the value of the discharge current at time 0.277 seconds. We will apply Kirchhoff's voltage law to the discharging circuit. UBD plus UDM plus UMN plus UNB is equal to zero. UBD is taken as UC. The voltage across a connecting wire is equal to zero. Then UDM is equal to zero and UNB is equal to zero. UMN is equal to plus RI because the positive sense is from M to N through the lamp. UC is equal to capital E over 2, which is equal to 5 volts. Small r is equal to 20 ohms. And the answer is minus 0.25 amperes. Part 2D. Deduce the instantaneous electric power received by the lamp at time 0.277 seconds. The lamp is considered as an ideal resistor. The instantaneous electric power of a resistor is given by Ri squared. R is equal to 20 ohms, the current is minus 0.25 amperes, and the answer is 1.25 watts.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.